bait release system seem very, very popular. But supposing you've got a plain lead with no built-in release system, how would you get around that problem?
Right, that is with a device that was the forerunner of the impact lead bait release system. It's called a bait shield. It's quite an ingenious little idea, and you can obviously see how they arrived at the impact lead. So we're using very strong fishing very strong tide. Deep water, strong tide, you're going to need a fixed wire grip lead, perhaps a heavy weight, or you want to swap it over. And you don't want to keep, you know, these leads are quite expensive, and you might be moulding your own, and we can't really mould the impact lead yet. So we use this bait shield. What it is, it's plastic, and it fits on the line just above the lead. And you can see it's got a hook on it, and the actual hook goes in that clip. Now, in this case, we've got the same rig as we had earlier, a one up, one down. Now this time, instead of the lead releasing the hook, what happens is the actual bait shield hits the water, and as it hits the water, it tips and releases the hook.
I see.
The force of the water tips it. Again,
yeah.
You can see the line coming down from the top. There's a slot in that hook.
Yep.
It comes down, and the bead forces it to come down and force the hook off the hook.
Mm.
Now, it's fail-safe. It was the original from Breakaway that started the really efficient long-range casting and fail-safe clipped-up rigs or clipped-down rigs.
Yep.
Simply because it comes off after the cast. Mm. Mostly, it doesn't come off in the cast, so you lose nothing in distance.
Right. Is it difficult to set up on the trace?
Not really. That what's involved is, obviously, you've got your normal trace. If you're using, we started off with a Patmaster.
Yes.
You need to put a stop of some kind above the bait shield. It's held on at the bottom with this piece of rubber tubing, and all it needs is a crimp above it and a bead, or in this case with the swivel on a hook snood below the lead, just a couple of beads with a snood, and then that crimp, or you can use this power gun stop knot again.
Yep.
But it's to lock it in place so that instead of going up the snood, it pushes it like that.
So it's the force of the water again that tips
right.
it up
yep,
and ejects
right.
the hook.
And then you can use whatever lead you like on the bottom. You can use a plane, you can use anything at all. There we go.
Very neat idea.